to notice. I read every single Sunday the Corner Office, which is a column in the New York Times. It's every Sunday and every Friday. Adam Ryan puts it together. He showcases a leader in many different industries. It could be the entertainment industry, a corporate executive, a nonprofit leader. And he interviews them about their leadership style, their leadership, how they hire, the things that the lessons they've learned around leadership. And one of the things that consistently I kept seeing month after month was a reference to improv. And all of these leaders saying that they had, you know, really gone out and tried improv at some point and learned about it and how it had been really transformational to their leadership practices. And I thought, well, that's interesting. What's that about? At the same time, my mother-in-law, who is a notorious, chronic planner, and this woman cannot be on one vacation with already planning the next vacation, 2 years out, received as a gift a book called Improv Wisdom from a friend. I think this friend was trying to give her a gentle, subtle hint, which is that not everything always needs to be planned, and that sometimes the best things in life are improv.